Good morning.
Morning.
All right, we're off to a good start. This is an exciting day for us, and I know it, this is something that all of you have. First of all, do you know who I am? Is there anybody in this room who doesn't know who I am? I'm Steve Scheinman. I'm the President and Dean of the Commonwealth Medical College, and I've been able to say that now for almost 11 months. you, I know, are excited, I assume. Nervous, I assume, anxious, maybe scared is not overstating it. And I want to tell you that we're excited too, and we're not the least bit scared. You're going to hear a lot, I'm sure you already have heard a lot, about the charter class, the pioneers, the people who took a chance on a school that hadn't existed and were such a remarkable group of young men and women. And they are a remarkable group, but we are just as excited about you. You are very significant to us for several reasons. First of all, you were the first class to enter TCMC after we'd reached the level of maturity of having had a class go all the way through all 4 years and graduate and go on to wonderful residencies. And so you're taking much less of a chance because you're here at an established school. You're the first class at this school, very significant for all of us, and perhaps a source of some anxiety for some of us, the first class of 100 students. And that is the size that we are at in our maturity. 4 years from now, we will have 4 classes of 100 students, and that's the size we plan to remain for the foreseeable future. And you have been chosen from the largest applicant pool in the history of the college. 5,002 people applied for the 100 seats that you're in right now. And so we could have chosen a lot. We could have filled several additional classes of excellent medical students, but we chose you. And so think about that for a minute. For me, you guys are very significant because you are the first class that I am welcoming to TCMC. I arrived here in the middle of September, and so the entering class last year was already well launched. And so I am thrilled to be welcoming you to the class, just as I will be thrilled to hand you your degrees in 4 years. So you are a very significant class to me. Now, you are, I'm sure, a little bit scared, and that's okay. For one thing, I'd be a little nervous if you weren't, a little anxious, a little scared. This is a huge task you're taking on. But I also encourage you to connect with that fear, with that anxiety. It's healthy, it's natural, and it will give you the energy if you harness it, to focus on your work and to really take the most advantage. If you were coming in here feeling relaxed, comfortable, and a little bit bored, you wouldn't be about to get as much out of what you're going to be learning here as you will. You are entering TCMC at a very exciting time in our history. I don't know how many of you saw the op-ed piece that the newspaper ran yesterday that I wrote about where we are, where TCMC is, and where we're headed. But we're at a very exciting place in our history. First of all, I bragged about you guys and about our first class of 100 students. I also talked about the expansion of TCMC's programs, the fact that we are expanding our footprint to additional clinical sites. A number of you will be assigned to the Pocono Medical Center in East Stroudsburg, which I believe over the next several years is likely to grow to be large enough to be considered a fourth campus, our East Campus. We're also in discussions with other clinical sites as well. And so our footprint is expanding in the region. We try to avoid being identified as a Scranton school. We really are a Northeast Pennsylvania school because our profile is everywhere. We are expanding programs. We've had a record number of applicants for our master's program, the MBS program, and a number of you are alumni of that program. And we have had so many applicants for that program this year that I am encouraging the faculty to think about ways to create a second track for the MBS program. That's something we're going to be exploring this year. And we are partnering with universities and colleges in the Scranton-Wilkes-Barre area that train other health professionals to expand opportunities for you guys to be in classes and to be in clinical settings together with students who are training in other health professions, because the future of the medical profession that you will be entering will be one of team-based care, in which professionals across all the health professions work together as a team on behalf of their patients, very different from the model that I was trained to practice in. And we're partnering with clinical entities in the region on a variety of clinical initiatives, including initiatives in healthcare quality and safety, partnering with hospitals and Blue Cross and residency programs in the region, and on mental health, which I'm sure you'll be hearing more about, and other programs as well. So I think it's a particularly exciting time to be arriving at TCMC. And I'm now about to say something that you will probably in your 4 years hear me say more than once, because it's more than a little true, that there has never been a more exciting time to be entering the profession of medicine. You have heard a lot, I'm sure, about all the headaches that practicing physicians have to face with regard to documentation and billing and staffing and regulations and all of that, and it's all real. But it all pales in comparison to what you are going to be able to do, the excitement and satisfaction that you are going to get over the course of your careers for having the great privilege and the great responsibility of taking care of patients. There has never been a time when physicians have had as many tools as you've got now, the things that you can do now, that physicians can do now for their patients. Many of them were unimaginable when I was in medical school. And many of the things you're going to be able to do for your patients are things that you wouldn't be able to imagine right now. And yet within the next decade or two will become standard opportunities for patient diagnosis and treatment and care. I encourage you to think of yourselves now as not just entering another phase of your education. Up until now, I suspect that you've been motivated primarily by your interest in the subject, by your interest in doing well, by your interest in grades perhaps, and all that I'm sure will still be part of your motivation. But you now have an additional motivation that trumps all of that. It is your obligation to your future patients, because they will be counting on you, they will be looking in you in the eye and trusting you, and they will be telling you things that they won't tell their families, and trusting you with their confidences and trusting you with their lives. And so as students, translate that into your experience as students. So when you're studying, think about that as your motivation. And so we are teaching you not just to have a head full of lots of information. The information itself is just a paradigm. Because as there's an old saw about medical education, that 50% of what we're going to teach you is going to be outdated in the next 10 years. We just don't know which 50% it is. And there's a lot of truth to that. What we are trying to teach you, what we aim to teach you, is how to be lifelong learners and how to edit out the stuff that we learn is no longer as relevant as it was 10 or 20 years ago, and to incorporate the new information that will be developed throughout the course of your careers long after you've left TCMC. And so we're teaching you not so much information as a way of thinking. And that way of thinking incorporates your obligation to your patients. And so your character and your integrity, the integrity with which you carry out your studies, translates to the integrity with which you'll be taking care of your patients. So when you look at yourself in the mirror every morning, take pride in the fact that you have that obligation to look forward to for the rest of your lives. You'll be carrying that obligation on your shoulders. It's a pleasure. There's I think, nothing more noble than the profession that you're about to enter. So here endeth the sermon. take all that with you, but this week is your orientation week. And so you'll be hearing more sermonizing from me on Friday when we have the wonderful white coat ceremony, when your parents will be here to hear some of this kind of stuff. And meanwhile, enjoy yourselves, have fun. And I don't mean just mean have fun this week, have fun this year. You'll be knocking yourselves out studying. Don't deprive yourselves of sleep, by the way. Because if you're studying at 2 in the morning, you can be confident in the knowledge that what you cram into your head at 2 in the morning is gone by 2 the next morning. If you don't have a good night of sleep going into your lectures, you don't retain as much. And if you don't have a good night of sleep the night after your lectures, you don't retain as much. This is well documented in the psychology literature. So take good care of yourselves and enjoy yourselves. Welcome to TCMC.
I'm Linda Berardi-Demo, and I'm the Associate Dean of Admissions and Student Affairs. And if I haven't met all of you, I read all of your applications again last night for the sixth time. So if I remember stuff about you, like where you went to high school or what your mother's first name is, it's because I really have read all of your applications at least 6 or 7 times. So I'm going to also join Dr. Scheinman and welcome you to TCMC. Like he, I have been here 1 year and 2 months, and this is the very first class that I had the opportunity to work with the entire year. So when I came in June of last year, the class was already picked. So you're the first group that I got to read all of your applications, interview many of you, and get to know you. So I guess I have to take full credit for the way this class, the admissions committee. That's why we have a committee. As Dr. Scheinman mentioned, there were 5,002 people that applied for admission in this class. We interviewed a very small number, 689, to get your class, which is 101. So let me spend a little bit of time and tell you a little bit about your class and your classmates. 72% of you are from the state of Pennsylvania. 25% or a quarter are from the Northeast PA, so the 16 counties that we serve. 46% of you are women. And 13 are alumni of our master's program in biomedical sciences. As undergraduates, you attended, 11 of you attended the University of Scranton. Big shout out to the University of Scranton. 8 from the University of Pittsburgh, which is my alma mater, so not that I had anything to do with that. There are a few Pittsburghers in this class, too. And then 8 are also from Penn State. Of the local colleges, there are 3 from Wilkes, 2 from Misericordia, 1 from Lycoming College, and 1 from East Stroudsburg. Other than Pennsylvania, 8 of you are from New York, 5 from California, 3 from Maryland, and 1 from New Jersey. And we also have 2 Texans. Yeah. And as I looked at the map today, I think the Californians actually did come the furthest distance. So from the East Coast, we think California is just one state. We really don't know where most of it's located. So you have to figure it out and let us know which one of you came from the furthest. Although you're mostly science majors, some of you majored in religion, history, Russian studies, and foreign languages. And some of you have advanced degrees. So there, other than our MBS degrees, there are people with a master's degree in occupational therapy, business, public and global health. And one of your classmates has a PhD in biology. So find them for when the tough that you got to study. Many of you speak more than one language. And some of the languages are Italian, Spanish, French, Arabic, Korean, Cambodian, just to name a few. And many of you... And Gujarati. I gave him my note. And many of you have worked globally in many countries, and some of the countries where you have studied or worked are Peru, India. There were several of you who did work in Kenya, Ireland, Costa Rica, and Argentina. And you're a very athletic group. There's some football players, wrestlers, cheerleaders, competitive swimmers, soccer players, cyclists, tennis players, marathon runners, and somebody who does kickball, which I had no idea was a... Who's raised their hand? You, yeah. I saw that. I was like, kickball, how cool is that? And one of our Californians. 30% of you are 25 and older. So this is a nice, what we consider non-traditional class. And many of you have worked in several other settings. There are 3 nurses, an occupational therapy, 2 business owners, 2 IT managers, and engineers. So in your class, there are some people who have done, in addition to kickball, some interesting things. There's a juggler. No one going to cough up and say they were the juggler? A juggler, a mechanic, a former Green Beret in the Special Forces. A couple of your classmates, too, started, I think, nonprofits. There are several writers, writing, some who had written books, and edited magazines. You're a very musical group, so I'm expecting the talent show to be really, really good this year. You play the piano, the violin, the clarinet, and I'm probably going to pronounce this incorrectly, Paul. Carillon. And he's going to tell us what that is.
Church bells.
I knew. I just wanted to make him do that. You're also dancers and singers. There's a DJ in your class. So like I said, the talent show is going to be really, really good. You also have classmates, three sets of classmates that have the same names. So there are two Andersons, two Lowrys, and two Jangs. So poor Ed during registration. Yeah, it's not good news for Ed during registration. Yeah. We also have one of your classmates who welcomed a new baby 4 months ago. So we have the first class. And you have several classmates who have who had children, not just recently, but had children before they came in. Last but not least, this is a very, very caring group of students. And I think when I reread your applications, there wasn't one student who didn't do a significant amount of community service. And so you'll find here at TCMC that the students really make all the difference in the community. So we hope and expect that you keep that all up. So my last thing that I want to say before I introduce the president of the Medical Student Council is I've been doing this a while. And every year, about 2 weeks into school, someone comes in and says, "Hey, Dr. Bredema, I think you made a mistake. Like, those other people are so much smarter than I am. And I think maybe maybe I don't belong here." And I say, no, you totally do, and we send them back out. And then, like, the next day, someone else comes in and goes, "Gosh, it's so hard. I'm not sure every single one of you deserve to be here and have earned it." And when I reread all of the wonderful things I thought about you as I went through the year, I'm honored to be your Dean of Students and to be your Dean of Admission. And this is going to be a truly wonderful year. So having said that, I'm going to introduce Greg Mendez, who is the president of the Student Council.
So hello. My name is Greg Mendez. I'm president of the MSC, which is the Medical Student Council. And I don't have that much to say, as they do. So I'm a second year. I'm one of 71. You guys are 101. And they don't come back. We don't come back till August 19th. So we have a couple more weeks to do nothing for right now. But we will, when you guys get here, we will have some kind of pairing up. We have peer mentors. So when the whole class gets back, we'll all have some kind of event we'll go to. We have monthly student council meetings. The meetings will start, the first meeting, I believe, is September 9th. Everything's already set for the three classes. We have, like, the presence of each class. 2 weeks or so, you guys will elect your own class president. And, you know, we'll work with you. The school's very small, so, you know, typically you would tell your class president what you want or something you want to change, and they come to us. But really, it's so small, you can just come to us. You can come to anyone you see. It'll only be first and second years here, because the third and fourth years are off, so it'll be tight-knit. And we'll try to have monthly meetings and monthly events. October, we have trick-or-treat and Thanksgiving dinner. But that's it for now, so, all right?